Come on, you bastard. Like... See, here's the stupid thing. We all have to use plastic forks, but any bastard can burn this place down because we're all allowed our lighters. Maybe they realize we'd be lost without our lighters. Come on, baby, light mine. Now that guy, Pinecone Man, is certifiably nuts. Not only does he hear voices, but complete conversations. I suppose you would too, though, if you'd been captured by aliens, not once, but many times.
I really need to get off these drugs. Maybe I need to see the doctor.
Well, good luck with that. Nobody ever sees the good doctor. But I could help you. See, I have a great rapport with the nurses. Just do me a favor. Don't lose the drugs just yet. Just pretend to take them, but give them to me.
How do I pretend to take them?
Oh, it's easy. You just hide them between your upper lip and your teeth like this.
And they don't check?
No, they only make you look underneath your tongue. They can't be bothered looking anywhere else.
Okay, thanks.
Say, what happened to you? How did you get sectioned?
How do you know that?
Oh, honey, I've got ears. Those nurses talk. And the doctor, he loves me. You can find out a lot just by being early to your appointment. Oh, don't worry about it. I'm hardly judging. I mean, I've been sectioned so many times, I practically have a tab with St. John. I know all the policemen. And besides, I mean, being in here, well, I mean, it beats sleeping in the street and stealing uneaten food off outdoor cafe tables.
Well, I had to leave my home. It was our home. But life has a way of turning to shit. Now, one minute you're in a relationship, and the next minute, he's saying he never really loved you. I mean, what does that mean? Never really loved you. You either do or you don't.
But that's where you're wrong, my love. It all depends on what your conception of love is. I mean, honestly, isn't love supposed to be unselfish, without expectations? You couldn't live off unrequited love, you'd go mad. I mean, that's why people throw themselves off bridges and starve themselves to death.
But I don't know why I screwed everything up the way I did. I just wanted him to love me. And everything just, you know, I lost my dog. My beautiful dog. I lost my job. Well, I guess it would help if it turned up. I thought I was handling this.
Don't worry. We all want to be loved.
This is like living in bloody Romania. Hey, Kardashians, how hard would it be to fill up the bloody water cooler?
Jordan, we will fill the water cooler when we are able to. But for now, you can get water in the kitchen, and it's only a short walk from here. I can come with you if you want.
I'm not a moron. I know where the kitchen is. And I'm not 5 years old either. I can walk by myself. Why can't you just fill it up?
Why don't you fill it up? Why don't you fill it up, you moron, you cupcake, shut up!
Watching the dogs.
Because I am not the one who fills it up. We have to wait for the water cooler supplier to come and refill the container. Did you go on a walk with Heather today?
No.
We are doing crafts tomorrow here in the common room. Would you like to do crafts?
You really are a robot, aren't you? Or are you just waiting out your time until you can get a better posting, Christchurch or Auckland? Mm. Surely an intelligent whiz like you can do better than this place.
Jordan, you seem to be very agitated today. Have you been keeping on your prescribed medication from the doctor?
Well, you see, that's just the thing. If I could get a moment with the doctor, maybe we could discuss just what medication would be best for me. But because I can never see the doctor, maybe he's given me the wrong thing. Maybe he's making me worse.
He's making it worse! He's making it worse! He's making my boogers come out!
Jordan, I sincerely doubt that would be the case.
You really have no idea, though, do you?
Hello, Jordan. Do you remember me?
Oh, you're kidding me, right? Of course I remember you.
Can you tell me what the problem is?
Oh, the problem is I'm going bonkers being locked up in here. I am a bloody alcoholic, not a psychotic. I don't need therapy. I need to get out of this prison.
If they catch you, they will kill you.
Well, would you like to talk about it?
Stop it.
You have been taking your medication, haven't you? You haven't just been pretending, have you?
For God's sake! If anything's going to make me go back to the bottle, it's you fuckers!
Fuckers!
Oh, why can't I just see the doctor? That's who I want to see.
All right. Well, you come with me. We'll go back to your room and we'll talk about it.
You really are a piece of work, aren't you? All right, I won't upset the natives. I'll go back, sit quietly in my room.
That's a good idea, I'll come with you. Jordan, did something upset you today?
Something upsets me every day.
I don't like the look of these characters. You can't trust them.
I just need to go to the kitchen and get a knife to slit your throat.
Hi.
Hi. How are you?
Oh, I'm okay. I just had a meeting with my lawyer.
Really?
Yeah. I have to take my mother to court for stabbing me and trying to hurt me. I just don't really like to talk about it, sorry, you know.
No, I can imagine.
So, I really like your hair colour. Is that natural?
Yes, yeah. Well, no, it's my real hair colour, but I've dyed it to my real hair colour.
Oh, I understand. Do you have a boyfriend?
Yes, well, I did once have someone very close to me.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did he hurt you?
Oh, no, that wasn't the problem. No, it was just, he didn't want me.
Oh, no, look, hey, it's not your fault. Oh, come on, hey, you can come to my room. Well, let's go, come on.
Well, how did we not see that coming?
You know, yeah, just sit down wherever. I'm leaving soon. I'm only in the psych ward so that they can protect me from my family. I mean, that's the only reason I'm here. I never told anybody this, but my mother tried to kill me once.
Well, that's horrible.
Well, that's why I need a lawyer. She drugged me and my sister, and she locked us in the sleep out. I managed to escape, but then my brother found us and he brought us back. Oh, she was so angry, and she hit me with a broom handle. Oh, and then one time, I managed to lock myself in the bathroom, but she got my father to unscrew the hinges. And I can't even remember what happened after that.
Oh, God, I'm sorry.
It's okay. I was bullied a lot in school. I mean, we moved around a lot, so when I came here, I just wasn't used to living in such a small town. I mean, I lived in Utah with my father for a while, then California. I was made fun of for having a Kiwi accent in Utah. Though, I liked California. It's much more, you know, sophisticated. But then when we came here, I was made fun of for having an American accent. See, I never really fit in. I never liked school. I was dyslexic, so I found learning really hard, and oh, the teachers are no help. They always put me in the lowest reading group at school.
You're lucky the world is in high school.
Yeah, well, I was really determined, so I made sure I did really well in all. I got excellence and all that, but just wasn't really for me. So I left school after year 12, I moved to Wellington and got a flat with some people I thought were really nice, but then turns out they told my family where I was, and my mother, she came and found me, and oh, I had to get a restraining order against her. I mean, she stared me in the stomach, and that's why I can never wear a bikini. It's because I'm too embarrassed by the scars. But do you want to see them?
Oh.
Hey! Oh. Do you want to see the guy I'm seeing? We're getting married soon. He's coming to get me when he can. I mean, he lives in Australia. But he's in the movies. He's filming right now.
Wow, that's exciting.
Yeah.
Yep.
Hey, do you still love your guy? Maybe you should tell him that. Maybe he just doesn't realise how much you love him.
He won't speak to me.
Oh.
Hmm. That might be because you threw a goldfish bowl at his head.
Oh, Zoe, I think I'd better go.
Oh, no. No, what? No, you can't. I'm not sure how to handle being on my own.
Oh, I'll call a nurse.
No, 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 please, please. No, no, nurse, no, no, please, please. Oh.
Shit. Well, that was close.
Yeah, but it's really freaked me out. I mean, she needs so much help. And she won't get it from her family, and you know, she can't stay in here forever.
Oh, with any luck she can. It's not so bad, you know. 3 meals a day, can't be bad. 5-star rating on TripAdvisor. Look at Agnes. She's not going anywhere. Are you, Agnes?
Poor Agnes. I wonder what she thinks about all day.
I doubt she thinks about much, really. She just needs a bit of contact. which is why I try to talk to her. Isn't that right, Agnes? Just blink, Agnes.
A candy-colored clown they call the Sandman tiptoes to my room late at night just to sprinkle stardust and to whisper, go to sleep, everything is all right. I close my eyes.
Ended up that way.
Her family screwed her up. I mean, why are any of us in here?
Oh, I couldn't say that about my family. I mean, they've been so patient and supportive.
Hey, you know, I was going to be a social worker once. I'd started studying at Otago. I mean, it wasn't like I'd never done a case study. I had all the experience with dysfunction I needed.
What happened?
Yeah, what always happens. I went and screwed it up with drugs.
Oh, would you go back? Would you want to get your degree?
Yeah, I could. Oh, that would give me something to grasp.
You'd be good at it. You could help Zoe.
Oh, don't feel sorry for Zoe. She has a perfectly normal family.
Oh, no. No, her mother stabbed her in the stomach. She showed me the cuts.
Cunning. She's a pathological liar.
Yeah, it never happened. She's nuts. She just wants the attention.
I mean, I'm a nutcase, but I don't lie. I can't stand people that lie. You know, I never understood people who pretend to be something that they're not. I mean, I don't pretend like I don't know why I'm in here. I'd rather be in here than out in the street. I know I'm an addict, but can you blame me? I mean, being high is just so much nicer than reality. Reality is just so boring sometimes. It just goes nowhere. I mean, what do you do about it? For example, I found out that my sister is my mother. Eureka. And my real mother is really my grandmother. Stay with me here, folks. You know, she used to hate it and say, you're going to grow up just like your sister. Which is really ironic when I think about it now. I mean, I used to find it funny that she'd never say, why are you taking drugs? Why, Gregory? Why? Don't answer. And I used to feel bad that I was hiding stuff from her. I used to feel bad that I was lying to her, but then I found out that my sister, my mother and my grandmother were hiding behind this huge made-up lie. All because they were ashamed of me. They were ashamed that I managed to exist and remind everyone that my sister had a baby at 14. Big freaking deal, huh?
That's pretty screwed up.
Well, I could easily have been an abortion. I guess there's that. I'm alive, and I'm not going back into that womb, darling.
Nobody wants you in their womb. You're safe. God. Oh, dear. You know, the sad part is, I don't belong in here. I'm not cray-cray like these poor bastards. I don't have voices in my head. Nobody's screaming at me, telling me I'm a loser. That's just the alcohol, you see. That's my disease. I can't help it. I'm an addict. I have an addiction. It's not my fault, though. I mean, my father was an alcoholic. My brother is an alcoholic. My sister, actually, is 3 months sober. That was not going to last. My mother was the enabler, you see. My dad used to wake me up in the middle of the night and make me listen to Irish rebel songs. Yeah, see, I'm not the only one, am I? He would start singing along and then just cry. So pathetic. He would cry and tell me how much he loved his children, but he just couldn't get his shit together. So pathetic, honestly. I used to go to school the next day, having had no sleep the night before. Real healthy family stuff. I was hungover before I even knew how to be. But then I started drinking, just to get the bastard out of my thoughts. I left home at 16, you know. Never looked back. I moved here. New life, new friends. But then Mum wrote to me to tell me that Dad had had a heart attack. She wanted me to go home, but I honestly couldn't see any reason why I should. You know, I hated the bastard, and my life here was good now. So why should I go and fuck it all up by going back home? But then she called me and told me that he had actually passed away. And I never went back home. Now, I used to think, I can control my drinking. It's only temporary. Tomorrow, I'll stop. Yeah, right. Got to the point where I started Googling how to cut back on your drinking. Yeah. Thought Google could save me. I mean, I have a master's, for fuck's sake. Meanwhile, I was hiding vodka in the bathroom at work. Sometimes I would quit for a week or two, a month, dry July, shit like that. Yeah, raise your hand, anyone? Sometimes, just to prove to myself that it was actually possible. But it doesn't take much. One glass, and I go right back. Rich with complaint, would you take me back to your house, which is tainted with lust and the listless shade? If I could have held you once more in that light, it's nothing to you, but it keeps me alive like a Valentine's Day. It's a Valentine's heart anyway. The king and the ages, they fall by the plan. It's always the tired and the ordinary man. It's the challenge, it's funny and such. I want to see you again. I want to see you again. It's so simple and plain. But I'll come back and see you again.
When is dinner? I'm so sick of being unloved.
Jordan, would you like to come see the doctor with me?
Oh, yeah.
How did you manage to see the good doctor?
I told them my medication was making me aggressive.
Clever girl.